Dieters. So in this video, we're continuing talking about a balanced diet. This is basically healthy eating 101. Part three, we are discussing micronutrients and also discussing portion size. So stay tuned. Let's get into the video. Returning subscribers, I appreciate each and every one of you. To all my newcomers, remember to subscribe and also like and share with your family and friends. So we're talking about micronutrients today. So micronutrients are the substances that are needed in smaller quantities by the body, but they are equally as important. So the first micronutrient that we want to talk about are vitamins. So vitamins are molecules that our bodies really need, but they cannot make on their own. So we really need to make sure that we eat a balanced diet so we can consume enough of these vitamins. Vitamins are larger molecules than minerals, and they come in either fat-soluble vitamins, which are your vitamin D, E, A, and K, or the water-soluble vitamins like the vitamin B and the vitamin C. So fat-soluble vitamins are vitamins that require fat for them to be properly used by the body, and they can also be stored for later use. Water-soluble vitamins do not need additional nutrients to be properly used by the body, but they cannot be stored or used at a later stage. So if you eat or drink more vitamin C or B than you need, it will be excreted in your urine. So good sources of vitamin C are fruits and vegetables and also nuts. You can also find them in supplements, of course, and dairy. So you can never have too little or too much. You just have to have the right amount of vitamins that your body needs, because remember we mentioned that your body does not make vitamins. So if you decide to take a supplement to make sure that you get enough vitamins that your body needs, make sure that it doesn't interfere with any medications that you're taking. Make sure you check with your doctor that, hey, I'm taking this type of supplement. Since you prescribed this medicine, is it still wise for me to continue, or should I stop the multivitamins while I'm taking this medication? So we are moving on to our next micronutrients and the last, which are minerals. Minerals are smaller molecules, much smaller than vitamins, as we mentioned before. They usually enter the body combined with another atom, and they can be used for a variety of body functions. Examples of minerals include iron, sodium, potassium, chloride. You've heard of all of these. So the body cannot make its own minerals, but they can be found in dairy, meats, nuts, fruits, and vegetables. So just like the vitamins, it is not healthy to have too little or too many minerals in your body. So that's all I have for you on the micronutrients. I just want to touch a little bit on portion size, because remember, we're talking about a balanced diet here. All of these micro or macronutrients have a daily recommended serving. So before you get something, let's say you have a food that you want to get, a snack, rice, you want to get some beans, read the package. It'll give you the daily recommended serving. So let's talk portion size. This is actually a very important topic because it contributes to weight loss or weight gain. So portion size is the amount of food that you choose to eat at any given time, but serving size is the recommended amount of food that you're supposed to eat for that mealtime or maybe for the whole day. So portion size can be more or less than the recommended serving size. So you always need to make sure that you stick to the serving sizes. Even all these things that we say are unhealthy, like ice cream, granola, all these things, sugary things, they have a serving size. And if you stick to the serving size, a lot of the times you will not go above your calorie goals. One of my favorite snacks, I know I substitute them for popcorn, but I love Pringles. They have a recommended serving size. And always when I stick to the serving size, I find that I can stay within my calorie limit for the day. So remember, before you buy anything, or when you buy something, before you consume anything that is packaged, you can read the label and see what is the recommended serving size, and that can actually help you so you don't overconsume calories. Make sure you have a food scale in your house so that if the serving size is given in grams or ounces, you can easily weigh it and you know how much you're supposed to eat. Because sometimes it can be deceiving to eyeball things, especially when you think you know and you don't know. You just need to have a scale and you'll be on the safer side of things. I would also encourage you to have measuring cups and measuring spoons so that if it's measured in terms of cups or teaspoons, you just know, okay, 1 teaspoon of olive oil, 1 cup of rice, all those things can really, really be helpful to help you to gauge the portion size versus the recommended serving size. You also need to pay attention to what you drink. The number one best drink is, you guessed it, water. Water is calorie free and it is necessary for a variety of functions in your body. So you can never go wrong with water. It makes your skin look good, helps digestion, many benefits of drinking water. So before you think about anything else to drink, drink a lot of water. I would urge you to stay away from sugary drinks because they tend to be calorie laden, okay? Calorie dense. Energy drinks, juices and sodas, even fresh squeezed juices. We've dealt with it before in a previous video that I'm going to put right here. So you can see that it's very easy to consume a lot of calories when you're drinking these fresh pressed or fresh squeezed juices. So pay attention to what you're drinking. Milk, definitely you have to stick to the serving size. A lot of these brands, they make you stick to 1 cup, which is 250 mils per meal. So I think if you stick to that serving, you're not going to overconsume the milk. Don't drink the whole box or the whole packet of milk. Chances are you're overconsuming it. Other drinks, any sugary drinks, you definitely need to stick to the serving size or just don't consume them at all. So anyway, Blank Dieters, that's all I have for you in this video. Remember to like, share with your family and friends. Also, leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you think about what we're talking about. I want to hear your thoughts, and I'll definitely get back to you down in the comment section. Remember to also subscribe if it's your first time here and check out some of my other content and also some of the previous videos that I did on this topic. Till the next video, bye!